Welcome to PC Analytics. Today, we're going to dig into the differences between the Peerless Assassin 120 versus the 120 SE. We've got our test bench right here, ready to put these coolers to the test and give you all the information you need to make the perfect choice for your setup. Both of these coolers have dual towers with 6 heat pipes. Each cooler uses the same two 120mm fans, the TLC12, with the ability to add a third fan. So, what's the difference? Well, it all boils down to the look of the cooler as well as the radiator height. The SE version has a traditional heat pipe finish with a smaller radiator than the non-SE version. Alternatively, the regular version has a clean heat pipe finish with a taller radiator. With that in mind, let's see how these radiator differences translate into performance differences. We've tested both coolers over idle, high, and overclock temperatures and have two sets of charts to show you. One that looks at performance normalized by percent speeds, and one that looks at performance normalized by noise levels. In our first set of charts normalized by percent speeds, we have temperatures on the left represented by the solid line, noise on the right represented by the dashed line, and percent speeds on the bottom. For this graph, lower is always better. Let's take a closer look at their performance. During idle, both coolers perform similarly, generating a comparable noise profile at lower RPMs. However, as we increase the wattage, the CPU is rated 105 watts. We can observe that the SE version offers slightly superior cooling performance at lower RPMs. But this advantage decreases as the fans approach 100% fan speed. Interestingly, even when we push the CPU to overclock levels of 125 watts, both coolers deliver the same cooling performance. In our next set of graphs, we have charts normalized by noise levels. At idle, the coolers continue to perform similarly. And as we increase the wattage to 105, their performance profiles remain almost identical. And even when we push the CPU to its limits at 125 watts, this performance trend continues. And if you're curious on how the Peerless Assassin compares to other coolers, you should check out this video comparing the Peerless Assassin to the golden benchmark, the NHD15. Thanks for watching. And if you found value in this content, I invite you to support this channel by hitting that like button or subscribing. Your support is appreciated.